You know, a little bit more about Trump. I don't want to get your opinion on this. Is certainly there's been a lot of question. I think that this is really part and parcel of the Mueller investigation about his relationship with Russia and Putin personally. And certainly there's a lot of bipartisan agreement, in the Congress, in the intelligence community, that Russia has made a habit in recent years of very aggressively going after American interests, trying to sow discord. I think wherever you are in the political spectrum, I think you can agree that that's not a good thing and that it is happening. And I think as a Democrat, I think that President Obama in the 2012 election was wrong to kind of make fun of Romney's warnings about this very issue. How would you comment about that?
I agree, but we're not a stranger for doing the same thing. We, in essence, are accusing the accuser. We're the accusers of being guilty of the same crime. So to validate their involvement in the last election, I'm still waiting to hear the evidence. I know it's still being under the investigative committee. So I'm still waiting to hear the true findings. It's still out. Give me evidence. If there's collusion, what, on either side, if it was the Hillary's campaign or if it's Trump's side, that needs to be exposed. The question is the time when the OIG report will come out. We don't know yet. So their level of involvement, I don't know. I can't answer the question. But if there's a high level of involvement that swayed the vote or the election, then we'll have to deal with it at the time. But it's too early, in my opinion, to tell without the evidence and the facts.
Well, I don't think we need to necessarily wait for the investigation to unspool every last bit of information here. I think that Occam's razor says that it's logical that Russia is actively, not only in America, but all over the world, trying to undermine democracies. And I think Russia is not our friend. I mean, Trump, I think, is right to try to cautiously have a better relationship with Russia. But you need to be super mindful of the fact that these people are not our friends. The government is not a friend of America.
I agree. I think in time we'll find out a little bit more information on that, their involvement in our last election. But you're right. You always have to be very cautious. But if you study the art of war, mm-hmm. remember that little phrase, mm-hmm. keep your enemies closer.
I thought that was Corleones, actually, but okay.
Was it Corleones?
No, it is art of war, though.
So, yeah, I believe strongly that the international policy relationship, you need to mend, you need to create bridges, regardless of how caustic the relationship is. So distancing and shutting them down, going back into a Cold War, is just reversing the advances we've had under, honestly, that 50-plus years that we were under Cold War. That was just brutally cold. But if we can maintain some level of diplomacy, let's do it. If they are, and we're guilty of the same. Let's be honest there. We've interfered with other elections throughout the world. Let's be mindful of that. So when we point fingers, that finger's being pointed at us as well. So, yes, we have to deal with Russia. And I think he's doing it very smartly. He's going with measured response, I think, like anyone should do. Measure it, be balanced, then weigh out the fact of the evidence as it floats to the top. And because right now there's a lot of things percolating that's suspicion, that's really, in my opinion, not really validated. So give me evidence, and I think Trump's handling it right with the sanctions. So keep those sanctions tight, but more importantly, keep that door open, keep that line open, so you can have a discussion. Because once you close that line down, that's when the whole world changes. You have China, you have Russia. You got to be very mindful and careful of our relations with them and North Korea.
Yeah, and it could just be diplomatic posturing. But the same intelligence agencies that are giving him information on Syria basically sat down and said, Russia has done this. So I thought the sanctions he put on the oligarchs were tough. I mean, if you want to get to Putin, you go after the oligarchs because that's who holds his money. And he seems to be wanting to walk that back a little bit. Do you feel like he's having a tough time negotiating how tough to be on Russia versus still wanting to keep an open line of communication? I mean, it's obviously a hard path to walk.
It's a difficult one to balance, and you'll see that more and more. But he loves doing what they call trial balloons. He'll put it up there. He'll go hard. Only he'll bring it in, kind of like the DACA thing. Remember the DACA thing? Mm-hmm. Well, instead of the 800,000, we'll give you 1.5. I mean, that was an amazing way to negotiate and bring all the Democrats to the table and see where they went with it. And they didn't go anywhere with it. So that's his business style and his, of course, administration style, is to put it out there, bring it back, negotiate hard like he has with other countries. I admire that. And I guess history will tell the success of it. But so far, so good. But him pairing back, it's probably not a bad thing. He probably has some good intel of why he's doing it. But we know Putin, man. He's hardline. Putin will only respect strength. Only. If you don't stand up to that man, you might as well forget it. You just leave the room because you won't get anywhere. Your relationship like it did with Obama. So he has to be strong, but he's paring it back for reasons I'm not aware of. But I have to put my trust in the president that he's getting good intel and he's moving it forward. And hopefully it will end up being the right decision.
Well, I want to get to tax cuts. Before that, you talk to a lot of voters, I'm sure, out where you're going. And are there some Republicans that you talk to that are frustrated that there's not a wall? Because you talked about that deal. And, I mean, he cut DACA. And Democrats have said, we were willing to do the wall for DACA. And do you hear some pushback from Republicans you talk to of who thought for sure that there would be a wall by now, or at least the process of getting that diplomacy put through or that policy put through? I mean, that deal was on the table.
It was, but it wasn't good enough. You know, if you've known, witnessed his style over time. And he actually put the numbers up a little higher on DACA, by the way. I think he really was looking for most of the funding coming in or approved. So, you know, he's very creative when it comes to getting, you know, what he needs to get the job done. I say it's not over yet. I say give it some time. You're going to start seeing some changes in the omnibus, because omnibus is not the budget. Mm-hmm. It may change between year and now and year end. So all in all, that's the beauty of what we do in business and in government. Nothing's static. Things will change, hopefully for the better, with the right influence in the right direction, and technically not strategy, because even today strategy is outdated, I'm finding. Mm-hmm. So today is you have to be very nimble. You have to adjust quickly. So getting the budget for the wall that may come from a different avenue, don't know yet. I don't think – I think what they're really upset with the Republicans was the omnibus. That's what you're referring to. Mm-hmm. This is signing off with Planned Parenthood and all the rest. But again, there's a lot of time between now and year end. There could be a lot of adjustments. So – I think it was successful in getting the budget for the military. That has been, I don't know how many years now. It's been about at least 5-6 years now that the budget has not increased. It actually decreased over time. And we needed to retrofit or just outfit our military with some replacement inventory and equipment that we left over in the Middle East. So that was part of the reason, and I'm glad he did that. As a veteran, I'm glad he did that. So you give a lot sometimes to get a little. Sometimes you give a little to get a lot. So we'll see how this plays out.